This week, President Obama came out in support of same-sex marriage, but some people think that being gay is a choice, and when they see their children showing so-called feminine traits, they hope something called reparative therapy will cure them. This week, California may become the first state to actually ban this type of therapy. The vote is Tuesday. And I spoke recently with someone who grew up dealing with this therapy about how it affected him.
When Ryan Kendall was 13, his mother read his diary and discovered he was gay. That was the beginning of the most painful years of his life.
For years, I thought that God hated me because I was gay.
Ryan says his parents were determined to change him. They signed him up for what's called reparative therapy with the National Association for Research and Therapy of Homosexuality, otherwise known as NARTH. Reparative therapy, aimed at changing sexual orientation, has been used for decades as a way to turn potentially gay children straight.
Every day I would hear, this is a choice. This can be fixed.
And did you believe that?
I never believed that. I know I'm gay just like I know I'm short and I'm half Hispanic. And I've never thought that those facts would change. It's part of my core fundamental identity. So the parallel would be sending me to tall camp and saying, if you try really hard, one day you can be 6'1".
Ryan says he was treated by Joseph Nicolosi, a clinical psychologist who today is still associated with NARTH.
The constant refrain was the religious one, that this is something that makes God cry, that this is something your family doesn't want for you.
At his office outside Los Angeles, we asked Nicolosi if he remembered treating Ryan Kendall about 14 years earlier.
I'm not familiar with the name at all.
His parents have provided bills from your office.
Yes,
there have been checks written to your office, but no record.
No.
He says that your therapy was quite harmful. He said that you told him to butch up, quote unquote.
Never. It's not our language.
When somebody says, people like yourself, others are trying to get the gay out of people.
That's a terrible way of phrasing it. I would rather say we are trying to bring out the heterosexuality in you.
Nicolosi says he's kept hundreds of children from growing up to be gay. He credits this man, George Reekers, a researcher and big believer that homosexuality can be prevented. Reekers worked as a doctoral student at UCLA in the 1970s in a government-funded experimental program later called Sissy Boy Syndrome. Reekers treated a boy named Kirk Murphy. To turn around Kirk's so-called sissy behavior, Kirk was repeatedly asked to choose between traditionally masculine toys like plastic knives and guns or feminine ones like dolls and a play crib. If he chose the feminine items, Kirk's mother would be told to ignore him. Kirk's siblings told Anderson his outgoing personality changed as a result of the therapy.
He had no idea how to relate to people. But it's like somebody just walked up and turned his light switch off.
George Reekers considered Kirk a success story, writing, his feminine behavior was gone. Proof, Reekers said, that homosexuality can be prevented. Kirk's family says he was gay and never recovered from the attempts to turn him straight. In 2003, Kirk took his own life. He hanged himself from a fan in his apartment. He was 38. Our producers tracked George Reekers down in Florida.
What do you say to the family if they say that the therapy that you did with him as a child led to his suicide as an adult?
Well, I think scientifically that would be inaccurate to assume that it was the therapy. But I do grieve for the parents now that you've told me that news. I think that's very sad.
According to the American Psychiatric Association, the potential risk of reparative therapy is great, including depression, anxiety, and self-destructive behavior. The association says therapist alignment with societal prejudices against homosexuality may reinforce the self-hatred already felt by patients.
Dr. Nicolosi says his therapy isn't harmful, and he only treats people who want to change. Not true, says Ryan Kendall.
It led me to periods of homelessness, to drug abuse, to spending a decade of my life wanting to kill myself. It led to so much pain and struggle, and I want them to know that what they do hurts people, hurts children, has no basis in fact, and they need to stop.
Randy Kaye, CNN.
And once again, the vote in California to ban this therapy is Tuesday. We'll keep an eye on it and let you know the outcome. We'll be right back.